Assalamu alaikum everyone. How are you all? I hope everyone is fine and doing great. So I'm back again with another update related to Saudi Arabia. So at last, as you know, the good news related to international flights, but I can see many of the people are still confused and I'm getting a lot of questions related to international flights. That who can travel to Saudi Arabia and what are the categories of the people who can travel to Saudi Arabia. So this video is to clarify your confusion and make everything easier for everyone to understand. So just now Saudi Airlines has announced the travel requirements for flying back to Saudi Arabia, and GACA also announces the readiness of its international airports for travel to those included in the exceptional categories. In this video, every single confusion that you are in and you couldn't understand what is going on, this video is the answer of every question. So I will try my best to tell you every bit of the info I have gotten from the official source. So before starting my video, I request everyone to subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification bell to get notified whenever I upload my video. Now I want everyone to watch this video till the end. Yallah. So welcome back everyone. As you can see here, I'm on the official website of Saudi Airlines. First, you have to select and open Saudi Arabia from the list, and you will see here written last updated 15 September 2020 Saudi Arabia time. Dear Saudi guests, if you are flying to the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, you are kindly requested by health authorities in Saudi Arabia to follow health guidance below to keep you protected when you travel with Saudi. Number 1. GCC citizens, guests and holders of valid visa, exit entry, business residence, ikama and visit allowed to travel from and into the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Number 2. All arriving guests must provide negative PCR test certified issued from a verified laboratory within 48 hours before arriving to the Kingdom, and guests who did not provide the certificate will be denied from boarding the airplane. Number 3. Above points not applied on countries that suspended from traveling to from the Kingdom in order to prevent this spread of the virus as decided by the competent committee as a result of virus outbreak in these countries. Number 4. All guests must fill out and sign health disclaimer form below, then hand it over to health control center upon arrival at airport. Number 5. All guests will undergo 7 days self-quarantine at home, 3 days for health practitioners with negative PCR result at the end of self-quarantine period. Number 6. All guests must download and register on Tataman and Tawakkalna applications. Number 7. Guests must assign home location through Tataman app within 8 hours of arrival. Number 8. Guests must monitor virus symptoms and immediately call 937 if any symptoms appear, or go to the primary healthcare center or emergency if necessary. Number 9. Guests must do daily health assessment in Tataman app. Number 10. Guests must follow precaution procedures during self-quarantine at home as stated in the health disclaimer form.
Saudi Airlines have given the links of Tataman and Tawakkalna app. You can download it from Apple Store as well as Google Play, and at the bottom open the form where you will find the disclaimer form from the Ministry of Health.
So here is the latest circular from GACA, General Authority of Civil Aviation. Everyone was talking about if international flights have started, where is the circular from GACA? So here is the statement from GACA of Saudi Arabia. I am going to read it out. This statement is published today, 15 September 2020. GACA announces the readiness of its international airports for travel to those included in the exceptional categories. Based on the issuance of the kind approval and according to what was raised by the competent authorities in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia regarding the latest developments of the confrontation of the virus pandemic in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, the first international flights began on Tuesday morning after permission for travel was given for exceptional categories. The General Authority of Civil Aviation, GACA, confirmed the operational readiness of Saudi airports for this stage in coordination with the Ministry of Health and the relevant government agencies within the airport facilities. GACA indicated that the conditions include not allowing non-Saudis to enter the territory of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia except after submitting evidence that they are free from infection of the novel virus based on a recent testing from a reliable and approved authority outside the Kingdom, and no more than 48 hours before the date of arrival at the airport.
Further, travelers workers should adhere to the health preventive measures that impose home quarantine for those coming from outside the kingdom for a period of 3 days, provided that there is a negative PCR test result for a sample taken 48 hours after arrival in the kingdom and that they are free from any symptoms of suspected infection of the novel virus. It is worth noting that GSA will update the approved health protocols for travel at this stage in the traveler's guide. Meanwhile, the date set for lifting the suspension completely for international flights will be announced 30 days before January 1, 2021. The Ministry of Health, if required at that